The size and scope of the massive wildfire burning in Yosemite National Park is staggering. At its peak, 5,100 firefighters were fighting a blaze larger than the city of Chicago at a cost of nearly $100 million. The fire that is destroying hundreds of square miles of wildlife habitat and sensitive ecosystems, California's third largest fire in history, was sparked by a hunter's illegal campfire. For assistance in controlling this inferno, firefighters are turning to the U.S. military for help. Called into service and flying high above the flames and smoke of Yosemite is the MQ-1 Predator, an unmanned drone. After becoming a household name following tours in Iraq and Afghanistan, the Predator is Cal Fire's important eye in the sky. This remotely piloted aircraft starts its daily mission at an unassuming airfield east of Los Angeles.
On first thought, it's just a completely unusual piece of technology. It looks like a strange alien bug. It's extremely aerodynamic, it's extremely sleek looking, but also like it comes from almost a different planet.
It's the MQ-1 Predator. It has a propeller versus a jet engine. The wingspan on this aircraft is approximately 55 feet long. It's bigger than your average general aviation plane.
I can see one camera here
and one there.
One under here.
Yep.
So two cameras, one stacked on top of the other.
And then this one,
you've got
the MTS ball, which has multiple cameras, and he can control it and move it.
And what are the different specs on the cameras? I mean, are they intended for different purposes?
Different uses. There's basically a daytime camera, a nighttime camera, an infrared camera. And it, you know, detects body heat and temperature.
Is the sensor ball here, is this the most expensive piece on the equipment?
It is. I don't know the exact numbers, but the cost of the ball is approximately half the cost of the aircraft.
So this is the aircraft that's actually launching today?
This is the aircraft that's launching. My crew are doing their pre-flight checks, and they work with the pilot and make sure the plane is in working order before they take off.
This will take off at 6 a.m. Where is it going to go?
We're basically tasked to fly up to the fire area and check out the fire as it's burning.
How long will it stay up?
We have a full fuel load. It can stay up over 20 hours.
So where are we headed now?
This is where the pilots and the sensor operator sit when they control the aircraft.
This is the cockpit,
this
essentially.
This is. Yep, you've got the pilot on the left-hand side, and the sensor operator sits on the right-hand side. And the screen that they're seeing is what's actually coming from the aircraft.
So they are flying the aircraft right now.
Exactly.
So that sensor ball that we saw is what the sensor operator is operating. The MQ-1 is up in the air right now. It's headed off to Yosemite. In about 45 minutes, there'll be a handoff via satellite to March Air Force Base. For the past 3 weeks, Captain Jeremy Salzoni of Cal Fire has been in effect living at March Air Reserve Base. He's been embedded with the 160th Reconnaissance Unit in order to coordinate the intelligence provided by the MQ-1. Tell me about the magnitude of this fire up at Yosemite.
The accessibility of this fire is what makes it extremely complicated and why it's grown to the size it has. With the inaccessibility around the entire area of the fire, it just makes getting from one point to another very difficult. Now, turn the camera on the ground and within 30 seconds, yep, there it is. The information is so rapid and so accurate, so immediate, that it's kind of hard to believe that I ever walked these things in the past. We're able to watch real-time information. I can see where the fire is, what the fire is doing, potential hazards coming up, maybe advantageous areas to get firefighters to maybe catch it in certain areas that you wouldn't see with the naked eye.
And that potentially life-saving information is being put to use here.
A really big operation here.
At the California Rim Fire's Incident Command Center near Yosemite National Park.
So this is the Air National Guard Mobile Emergency Operations Center that we've rolled out here in order to help facilitate coordination and command and control of remotely piloted aircraft operations here in support of the Rim Fire incident. So this is where all the magic happens.
All right.
It can throw embers up to as much as a mile out ahead of it. So we'll need to scan a wide scan first and then zoom in on any kind of heat signatures that we find.
One of the biggest advantages the MQ-1 brought for us was the ability to geolocate the fire line. Infrared imagery's been around for a while, but the ability to put geographic coordinates against something and immediately transmit those to us here where we can transfer those to a map and make that readily available, invaluable.
What we're looking at is the video feed, full motion video, from the MQ-1 Predator. In this picture right here, you can see how the smoke is masking the fire, so it's really hard to determine where the fire line actually is. So here, he's now blended in that infrared on top of the day TV, so now we can clearly see where the fire line actually is.
Hey, Captain, how do you feel about how this went?
I think it was a huge success. I've seen some violent things, but I'm not sure I've ever seen anything more violent than how strong this fire was, how much it was crowning, how fast it was moving, and how difficult it was for folks to contain. And I believe 100% that we made a huge difference.
What has access to this technology brought to the firefighting effort?
I'd have to give you the primary is the life safety, the ability to keep an eye on the men and women fighting the fire. In regards to firefighter safety and firefighting, I think we're just scratching the surface as far as its potential.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology is a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.